out the intersection of these two issues. You see, this water services bill is an arrogant and undemocratic fudge. And that arrogance and that contempt for democracy that is displayed in this water services bill is the same arrogance and contempt for democracy that produced the vote to exit in the UK, and indeed, which is... wait, no, I'm not. You see, this is the point. This is the point. You see, you don't get it. The establishment don't get it. There is absolutely enormous, widespread disaffection and alienation from the political Portugal, and tragically, it is also reflected in darker and more dangerous manifestations of disaffection with the rise of the vile, and that's what they are, the vile xenophobes of UKIP, the vile Boris Johnson, the vile far right across Europe. But why are these forces rising? Precisely because of the failure of the establishment. That's why it's happening. And the establishment would want to take a long, hard look at itself. It's in absolute panic now over Brexit, just as you were, just as you were in panic, faced with 250,000 people on the streets, panic-stricken by it. That's the truth. And it has rocked you. It has brought the two parties that have dominated this state for its entire history. It has brought you both to your lowest ever ebb. And it has close to eliminated the Labour Party because they joined that club and got it wrong as well.
Deputy Coppinger, you're not allowed to make comments across the floor like that. Make them to the chair if you wish. I'm asking all members to respect other members, please.
Okay. Chair, the clock's running on now.
Sorry, I want Deputy Barrett to be allowed to conclude his contribution, and you will have an opportunity, Minister, at the end of the debate to reply, and if you wish to clarify issues, you can do it then. So please, continue.
Yeah. I am sticking to the issue. It's about honesty and democracy. That is our main problem with this bill. That you just don't believe in democracy. That the people have spoken. They have spoken clearly and unequivocally, but you won't respect their decision. And if anything is going to fuel further alienation and disaffection from politics, from the political establishment, it is the contempt that you are showing. And to be honest, even from your own point of view, it is utterly self-defeating. If you had any sense, you'd get this issue off the pitch so we can move on to other things, because you're just going to keep digging a hole for yourself if you don't respect the decision. And you see, the reason you won't isn't just the contempt for democracy, because it is also because you are playing a trick on the people, just as you did with the bin charges. And you see, that's part of the reason there was such a revolt against water, because people will be fooled once, he's going to do it again. People will be fooled once, but they're not going to... See, you just can't bear it. You can't bear it that you've been beaten. And the people have seen through you. You knew, and Fianna Fail knew, when they first proposed the introduction of a 400-a-year water charge, that it was going to lead inexorably to privatisation, a fact confirmed by the European Union. You also continue to recycle the lie that it was going to be off balance sheet when Eurostat exposed that lie and admitted in their ruling that privatisation was always envisaged. Just as with the bins. You knew once the charges came in, privatisation was coming, and that's what you wanted. And the reason you won't abolish now is because you want to come back at this. for the same reason, to get hold of this precious resource and make money out of it, commodify it. So you are trying to trick people, and that produces disillusionment. And the last point I just want to make is this. You see, in your opposition to us, you put up spurious opposition on the basis, oh, we've got to do something about the water infrastructure, and we heard it again from Deputy O'Sullivan, where are we going to get the money, and so on. Let me just read from the Irish Water Business Plan. You see, if you want the facts, just read the plan. And compare it with the figures for water investment in the years previously. I'll just go through them, okay? Water investment plan of Irish Water, 343 million, 214, 391 million, 215, up to 522, 216, then 533, 2018, it's going up to 595, and so on. An average of 600 million. Sounds good. This is the big water investment plan. This is the plan. Yous are serious about fixing the water infrastructure. But then you go back and you look at the previous figures. What was the high water mark, if you'll excuse the pun, of investment in water infrastructure? It was in 2008, 699 million, higher than any of the figures envisaged by Irish Water. When did it drop? In 2009, courtesy of Fianna Fail, to 679, and then in 2010, a massive drop in investment to 519. Then in 2011, it drops again by another 100 million to 467. Then in 2012, it drops to 442 million. And by this is now under you guys. And then in 2013, it drops again to 411 million. Who cut the investment in water infrastructure? Fianna Fail, the Green Party, Fine Gael, Labour. And it's not going to go back up because you're spending 200 million. Can't bear it, can you? The truth hurts. Oh, the truth hurts. But the people won't be fooled.
Paul Murphy.